relation to his size, has more power in his hind legs than a kangaroo.
That's good to know.
This is fascinating stuff, Madeline.
My friend the doctor says the moon is made of apple pie. Once a month it's eaten by the sun. And that is why up in the sky I'll find as every month goes by somebody in the sky is making a Madeline. My friend the doctor says the stars are made of lemon drops and bigger ones are lollipops and nuts. The clouds are shops up on the tops that sell you sweets and soda pops. What do they call places in paradise?
Chatting with a cheetah. What a neat achievement it would be.
be.
Believe you me.
If I could talk to the animals, learn their languages, maybe take an animal degree.
A PhD.
I study elephant and eagle, buffalo and beagle, alligator, guinea pig and flea.
And bumblebee.
I would converse in polar bear and python. And I would curse in fluent kangaroo.
To name a few.
If people ask me, can you speak rhinoceros? I'll say, of course, Riss. Then I would.
Good for you.
If I conferred with our furry friends, man to animal, think of the amazing repartee.
Oh, I agree.
When I can walk with the animals, talk with the animals,
grunt and squeak
and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to me. For instance, Polynesia, how would I say good morning to old Jip here? In dog talk, I mean.
Simple. Woof, woof.
Was that it?
Yes.
Amazing. But what was all that leg-shaking business?
That's part of good morning. Most animal languages are a mixture of sounds and movements.
And you just put the two together then?
Squawk, who's a clever boy?
Excellent. Now let me try. Woof, woof. But she didn't answer me, Polynesia.
That's because that was your right leg. That meant good night.
Ah, sorry, Jip. Try again. Woof woof. She answered me, Polynesia. She answered me. I speak dog. It's incredible. It's impossible, but it's true.
A man can talk to the animals. It's a miracle. In a year from now, I guarantee I'll be the marvel of the mammals. Playing chess with camels.
No more just a boring old MD.
All thanks to me.
I learned to speak in antelope and turtle. My Pekingese will be extremely good. If I am asked to sing in hippopotamus, I'll say rhinoceros. Then I would.
If you just stop and think of it, there's no doubt of it. I will win a place in history. When I can walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they can squeak and squawk and speak and talk to me.
Yes, I will get a word to your husband. $298, Maddie. And with lobster, it'll be $499.
I think that's fantastic.
But I'm gonna need more than just languages before I can start my journey for the Great Pink Sea Snail. Long sea voyages cost money, but I tell you, it's gonna be the adventure of a lifetime. If you come with me, my friends, I hereby guarantee, my friends, together we will have the time of our lives. We'll share adventures great and small, amazing stories short and tall, make every day the most sublime of our lives.
We'll travel north, south, east, and west, the west, they say, is by far the best. There's more to see in life than someday.
Daddy. Here, it says open here. My word, it's a llama. Come on, lass, I think she's nervous. And my llama's a bit rusty. Not much call for it here in Puddleby. Here, Maddie, open the other end and give her a gentle shove, would you?
Doctor, there's another one up this end. There's two of them.
Two llamas? How thoughtful of somebody. Really, people can be awfully kind.
What are we going to do with them, Doctor? Maybe we could have llama races.
Or make ourselves a couple-faced overcoats.
Maddie.
Sorry, Doctor.
I don't believe this. It can't be. It is. It is. It is.
What? What? What?
It's a push me, pull you. Look.
What are they saying, Doctor?
It's rather difficult to understand.
It's a camel dialect.
With a rather thick accent.
But I'm That's how Dr. Doolittle raised the money to go on a voyage to find the great pink sea snail.
Jonathan Doolittle, you stand here accused of murdering an unknown woman by throwing her off a cliff into the Bristol Channel. How plead you?
She wasn't a woman, she was a seal.
A seal?
Yeah, like,
Her name was Sophie. A seal named Sophie, dressed in a bonnet and shawl?
Yes, I got them from the bearded lady at the circus. The shawl had this purple all around.
Enough about bonnet and shawl. Are you asking the court to believe that you took a seal named Sophie all the way into the Bristol Channel and then threw her off a cliff into the sea in a wheelchair? They won't ask why.
Certainly. She wanted to go to the North Pole to see her husband.
Her husband?
Yes. His name is Nigel.
And how do you know she wanted to go to the North Pole to see her husband?
She told me.
She told you? Are you in the habit of talking to animals, John Doolittle?
Yes, I do it all the time.
And may one ask how you acquired this somewhat unique talent?
Polynesia.
You studied in Polynesia?
No. I studied with Polynesia. She's my parrot.
Doolittle, what kind of fool do you take me for?
Well, I don't know you well enough, Judge, sir. But if your lordship permits, I would like an opportunity to prove my point to you by talking to any animal you care to nominate.
Very well, then. My dog Rufus is outside. Bailiff, call in Rufus.
Call
in
Rufus. Raise your right paw.
We can skip that formality. Ask him what I had for dinner last night.
Very well. Woof woof. Woof woof woof. Really? That much?
What's he say?
Oh, I'm grateful that your lordship acknowledges the fact that the dog was talking. For dinner last night, your lordship enjoyed the following 2 servings of broiled trout, followed by 4 servings of roast beef, roast potatoes, Brussels sprouts, and gravy, followed by 6 servings of blackberry pie with whipped cream.
It's not true. He's lying. I only had 5 servings of blackberry pie.
Thank you, Rufus. That will be all.
You may step down, Rufus. It appears the bearded lady has confirmed that she did lend you the bonnet and shawl. Mr. Blossom has reported a missing seal named Sophie, and there's no missing persons on the police reports. Therefore, you are acquitted to the count of murder.
Thank you very much.
However, your acts in the courtroom today have left little doubts in the minds of my distinguished colleague tonight that your behavior
interfere with animals has interfered with the public safety, and therefore you will be sent to the asylum of the insane. Do you have anything to say on your own behalf? Yes, I do. I do not understand the human race that has so little love for creatures with a different face. Treating animals like people is no madness or disgrace. I do not understand the human race. I wonder, why do we treat animals like animals? Animals treat us so very well. The devoted way they serve us and protect us when we're nervous, oh, they really don't deserve us. It's clear as a bell. Why can't we say noble as a frog? Why can't we say healthy as a hen? True, we do say devoted as a dog, but what we should say is chic as a giraffe, or pretty as a pig, eh? That will be a big day, boys. But when? But when? But when? When will we stop treating them like animals? Is the human race entirely mad? We can see a baby goatskin, or a lambskin, or a snowskin, and to them it's just a goatskin. Oh, it's terribly sad. Leather or some fancy fur or feather, do you stop and wonder whether you are bad? You have killed some beast or other. That you're wearing someone's brother? Or perhaps it's someone's mother in which you're glad. Like animals. Like animals. Like animals. It's true, we do not live in a zoo. But man is an animal too. So why can't you like me? Like animals. Animals. Take them below.
She belongs to General Bellows.
Oh, great. Now we'll all swing for sure.
I don't think so, Maddie. Since we've got his boat, he has no means of pursuing us. What's our position, Jip? Whoa, whoa, whoa!
What'd she say?
She says there's a faint smell of garlic 10 miles to the southeast of us.
And what does that mean?
It means we're 10 miles off the coast of France. Don't you love life on the rolling deep?
Not really, no. If the great Lord intended us to go to sea, he'd have given us flippers.
Is someone cooking something? May one ask, what are you doing aboard the Flounder?
I was enjoying a quiet day on my uncle's boat until it was attacked and stolen by pirates. How about you?
I can't possibly have you along on this journey. We must turn around and go straight back to Bartleby. Immediately after lunch.
So where are we going?
Down to the Rapids Eastern, of course.
And where might that be?
Well, no one knows for certain. That's why we play a little game I invented. You take a map of a world, and you stick a pin in it, and wherever it lands, we go too.
That is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. I mean, you can end up in all sorts of terrible places.
I know. One time, I went to the Sahara Desert 3 times before I realized that Chi-Chi had stuck 3 of the pages of the atlas together with jam. But wherever that great pink sea snail is hiding, we'll find him.
How can you stand there and say what you're saying? I just... don't know. I must admit the Sahara is one place I'm praying we just won't go.
We'll see those fabulous places.
Well, obviously we're never going to find that, so couldn't we just go to the Greek islands instead?
Doctor, you look confused.
I am confused. I just asked the octopus which way to Easter Island.
And what did he say?
Well, he didn't say anything. He just did this.
That means he saw Sea Star Island 2,000 miles southwest of Spain 8 months ago, heading due north at a speed of 2 knots.
Good Lord, is that what I said?
Precisely.
Polynesia, that means I speak octopus. That makes 500.
Congratulations, Doctor.
We ought to have a party.
So, when Sea Star Island is coming this way at a certain amount of speed, and we're coming from this way at another amount of speed, we ought to meet somewhere around here.
What was that?
Crisis call from the seagulls. There's a huge storm dead ahead.
Oh, that sounds very exciting.
Can't we drive around it, Doctor?
I don't think so, Maddie. The latest long-range wind forecast wasn't too encouraging. And Jim said she could smell thunder.
I didn't know thunder had a smell.
It does if you're a dog.
Abandoned ship! Abandoned ship! Squawk!
I do hope General Bellows is paid for his boat insurance. Looks like he's gonna need it!
We've got to save all the animals.
and until the crash, I was pretty confident we were going to actually find him.
I'm confident that you'll still find him.
We must stop these ridiculous protests and address ourselves into the more important issue. Recapturing the lost lunatic Jonathan Doolittle. And someone get these wretched animals out of here.
No, General Bellows. These wretched animals and the people of Puddleby will no longer tolerate your outrageous political corruption and abuse of office. It's time for you to resign, Uncle Ethelred.
Yeah! Emma, how dare you speak to me like that?
And how dare you speak to the people of Puddleby like that? The animals of England are unanimous in their condemnation of your wrongful behavior towards them and John Doolittle. For once in your selfish and spoiled life, Ethelred Bellows, stop bellowing and listen.
We are the creatures of the world, and we will not tolerate a world where evil
behalf of the Puddleby Hunt, I mean Town Council, I hereby declare Jonathan Doolittle totally innocent of whatever it was he was supposed to have done. Clearly, he was treated with bureaucratic behavior, and therefore, of course, I have no knowledge of whatsoever.
Decided we wanted to get something for the three people, Zach,